topic of the day is the wax apple. So I hear that you brought some things for us to try and take
That's
a
right.
look at.
That's right, gotta check it out.
So let's take a look. The good thing about this jam is because the lembu fruit is so spongy sometimes, it's not hard chewy. All the fruit is actually very tender.
This is a lembu sparkling water.
Wow.
All right,
cheers.
Cheers.
Hi everyone, welcome to Jason's Table Fruit Lab, where we take a closer look at some of the amazing fruits of Taiwan. Today, our guest, Dennis.
Hey, Jason.
Hi, Dennis. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you finally. Heard so much about you. Yeah. I saw your programs.
Oh, thank you.
Love it.
Well,
love
I'm it. So glad you're here today. We're at the Fruit Lab, and our topic of the day is the wax apple. Lembu fruit, the scientific name is Syzygium semeragensis. So say that 10 times.
Wow.
Syzygium.
You got that pretty well down.
Syzygium semeragensis.
Okay.
And it's a really beautiful fruit that originally came from the Malay region of the world.
Okay.
And in the 17th century, the Dutch introduced it into Taiwan from Indonesia. Lembu comes from originally Malaysia.
Man, you did your homework. I mean, eating this stuff all my life. I was not able to produce.
The primary producing regions of lembu fruit are in Pingdong.
The southern part.
It's a crazy cash crop because the value of the crop for lembu fruit is over 10 million US dollars a year for Taiwan.
Really?
The crop.
Just on this one fruit?
That's
wow. That's pretty amazing.
So question for you.
Okay.
So for what purpose would they grow the wax apple tree? So is it they would grow the trees to shade things from the sun, or is it B, that they would use it to grow monkeys?
But knowing that Taiwan has a lot of monkeys, and this is a fruit that's easily accessible, I would probably imagine B.
Okay.
It would feed the monkeys.
Is he correct?
It's not.
No.
It was for the sun?
Actually, trees originally, lembu fruits were grown for shade trees.
Ah.
And let me tell you why. So the fast growing lembu tree can grow up to 25 to 40 feet tall. It's fast growing, the canopy spreads out, and it's a beautiful shade tree. So it grows tall, provides quick growth, and you'll see it planted down in lots of places in the south, originally as a shade tree.
I did not know that.
All right, so our first variety here. This one is called the Nanyang Pink. In the trade name, it's called Hei Zhenzhu, so the black pearl.
Oh, that's where that comes from.
All right, next one we have, this one is a very rare one. This is the Bai Yu.
I've never tasted that before, actually.
Very rare. A lot of people in Taiwan haven't had this before.
Yeah.
And we move on to this one, which is called the Hei Tang Barbie. Brown sugar, black sugar, Barbie.
Okay.
And you can tell just by the coloring, it's a much richer color and has a very high Brix, which is the sugar content in there. This one.
This almost looks unreal.
It looks fluorescent, right?
Right.
This one is the Sui Mi Tao. So this one is Sui Mi Tao peach variety cultivar. This one also known for its fragrance and aroma. The final one we have today, this one is the Xiang Sui one, otherwise known as the perfume. You know, I think it's interesting in Taiwan, people have developed really awesome ways of cutting fruit so you just get the very best part. Typical lembu fruit, you see there's the calyx here and it looks kind of like a little butt. But in Taiwan, typically people will cut it and they will cut out the inside just to remove this part.
What I do at home, when I cut these,
the
spongy part is actually still quite flavorful. It's just less juicy, right?
As it gets up to here, there's a little bit more density in the flesh, just like you said. This is super spongy, but I like that. It's kind of like a cotton candy texture.
It is.
I don't mind that at all. But again, sometimes at the blossom end, you can get a little bit of maybe some mold or other things like that. So typically, you cut that away. You don't want some off flavors.
Yeah.
But again, this is the beautiful lembu fruit.
This is it's the same fruit, but look at how many variations.
Let's taste test these. So here is the
Nanyang, that should be the...
Yes, the Nanyang pink, so...
All right.
Cheers. Okay.
Ooh, I love that. I almost feel like these are the most thirst-quenching type of fruit because it's so watery. There's so much juice in it. It's kind of like eating a watermelon.
Yeah, It's hard to describe, but you mentioned before there's floral notes in it. Yeah. When I taste it, there's almost a bit of like a grassy fresh taste mm-hmm. to it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's sweet, but not overly
not
acidic.
Overpowering, yeah.
I don't taste a lot of acid in there. It's just a very gentle sweetness with a lot of refreshing juice and a little kind of hint of vegetal kind of
yeah.
grass.
This has got to be hands down one of my favorites.
So that is the classic flavor. Mm-hmm. All right, and let's take a look at the white one.
Have you had this before?
I've not had this one before.
Yeah, this is...
So this is a special
new,
variety
huh?
Grown only in the Pingdong area. Obviously, colors, they do influence flavor, so let's have a go with this one.
Try it. Still crunchy. I feel like there's a bit of honey and pear.
Pear. Type,
right?
Pear.
Right?
This does have the texture more and also the flavor of like a pear, like an Asian pear.
Yeah.
Crunchy, honey. This one, the flesh is a little bit denser. There's a little bit more... crunch to it, I'd say. But the flavor, it seems to me just a little bit more intense.
Mm-hmm.
Hard to describe, but it does have those grassy overtones, which... On to number three, Heitang Brown Sugar Barbie. And let's have a taste.
Check, yeah. But for those of you watching, one of the reasons I really like these, not only the taste, but no seeds. They're easy to clean, easy to eat, and just the juice. I love this. This is one of my favorite.
So this one to me has a little bit more pronounced sweetness on it. Super juicy. Also, substantial flesh, but it's very tender, crunchy too.
Mm-hmm.
So the best way to keep lembu fruit,
mm-hmm.
wrap them in a little bit of newspaper, and then you can just put them in the refrigerator. The thing to watch out for with lembu is if you let them sit too long and they're not covered, they tend to lose moisture and then they get a little soft squishy.
Oh, you don't want to dehydrate.
Yeah,
right?
So keep them nice and
keep
hydrated.
Them moist. Mm. Oh, that's so good.
All right, one other one for you.
This is beautiful. I just gotta say, this really looks like a wax fruit.
Mm.
It's so beautiful. The skin is gorgeous.
You can see why they call it wax apple. It's kind of fluorescent-y. And this is the peach, sui mi tao.
Mmm, this one has more moisture.
Mm-hmm. This one's super juicy.
Yeah, has
and
more
this one has a little bit more acidity to me on my on the tongue, but this one is just, it's like you could squeeze it and you could have all this juice come out. And the last one we have is the xiangsui perfume. And you can see it's kind of a greenish shoulder here going down, but it's a nice, it's just the colorations are really pretty, almost looks like watercolor.
And there, yeah, this is the biggest one out of them there.
Gigantic. So it's monster lembu. Wow. Super pretty.
I love that.
All right. Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers. The fragrance, the flowery taste in this one, much more pronounced, right?
This one, just again, as you eat it, that sweetness just comes right to the forefront. I mean, it's just a really, really refreshing. All right, so question for you. If a wax apple has health benefits, is it A, that it helps people lose weight, or is it B, it aids in dealing with, you know, pain for that time of the month?
This stuff is pretty sweet.
Sure, okay.
I would imagine the sugar content to not be very low on any of it.
Okay.
So I would imagine it would be something else other than...
So you think B?
Yeah.
So is Dennis correct? No. Actually, the answer is wax apples are good for folks who are trying to lose weight.
Really?
So let me explain why. So wax apples, for 100 gram serving of wax apples, it actually only has 34 calories in it. So despite it having the sensation of being sweet, due to the structure and all the fiber in there it's a healthy thing. So especially in Taiwan, people know that wax apples can be eaten by folks who have diabetes. A lot of the sugary fruits in Taiwan are just not great for that, but wax apple is one of the things that you can have. So if you're trying to lose weight, high fiber, eating some before meal on an empty stomach can help with satiety and helping you with health. So
we learned
apples,
so much about wax apple
that you didn't know.
Yeah. Yeah, and we also learned don't listen to Dennis.
Dennis, it's time for our delicious experiment of the day.
All right.
So we have some lembu here, and we have two different things to dip them in.
Oh, this is vinegar.
Vinegar?
Rice vinegar or some sort?
And
yeah.
Here's the second dipping selection.
Okay, this is soy sauce and garlic?
Soy sauce with garlic.
Okay.
So please, let's have
with
a taste
this?
This. Yeah.
Yeah. I've never done this before. This is an experiment, or this is the entertainment part of the show. So they get to see what happens to us.
I mean, vinegar with fruit is not out of the realm of comprehension for me. Because if you think about it, if you're having a salad, like a Western-style salad, if you put apples or fruits in there, you have like a vinaigrette. I don't think it's that strange. So, okay.
That actually tasted not bad.
Option two.
Are you serious? Garlic?
Garlic and soy sauce.
This has got to be like the punk part of your show or something.
All right, so garlic and soy sauce.
You know, it's not bad either.
I don't know how I feel about this. Yeah. Only one of these is the traditional way that folks in Taiwan would eat lembu back in the day. Is the traditional way for folks to eat lembu back in the day, is it A, with the garlic soy sauce, or is it B, with vinegar?
I'll go with vinegar.
Vinegar. Yeah. So Dennis thinks that the traditional way of eating lembu fruit back in the day in Taiwan was with vinegar. Is he correct? No.
Hey, 3 for 3.
Don't bust the streak now. So Dennis, in fact, garlic with soy sauce is the traditional way of eating lembu fruits for folks in Taiwan, due to the fact that earliest lembu fruits and varieties were more bitter, more acidic, not as sweet. The soy sauce with the garlic was meant to mask some of those flavors. So I hear that you brought some things for us to try and take
a
look at.
Gotta check it out.
So let's take a look.
The first one I brought today, this is the dehydrated version of the wax apple. Now this way, you could ship it, you can get a taste of it all year round. Mm. And I really like it because as we try the fruit, it's not super fibery.
Yeah.
So when you make it into a dehydrated fruit, the texture is actually really, really good. Mm.
And what I think is really interesting, a lot of times when you get dehydrated fruit, you sometimes lose some of the nuances of the fruit, but I'm getting that grassy kind of floral
it's
taste
there,
on
right?
it. It's there.
Yeah.
And it just concentrates all that flavor of
All right.
This.
The second thing, some folks have made it into a jam.
Jam?
Uh-huh.
In my understanding, these products are all from the Pingdong region.
Look at the chunks of fruit that you can put into a lembu or jam, right?
All right.
Try it
Cheers.
Out. Yeah. I love it.
And I love the fact that the creamy kind of dairy flavors from the bread, buttery, really matches the
lembu. Well
yeah. And the good thing about this jam is because the lembu fruit is so spongy sometimes, it's not hard chewy. All the fruit is actually very tender. Mm. So a great way to have your lembu if you can't get fresh ones.
Oh, this one I love. Mm. Right?
Yeah.
You should bring Delicious. Home washes with you.
Last thing, something to wash it all down.
There we go.
Okay.
Here.
Thank you.
So this came about in the recent years. This wasn't around a few years back. This is a lembu sparkling water.
Wow.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Sparkling lembu.
Love this.
Has that fragrance in that. You can get that sweetness just gives you that lembu sweetness.
All right.
Perfect ending to your visit to the fruit lab. And I think, folks, next time you take a look at a lembu, you might see it a different way. And when you're coming to Taiwan, try all these different things, and you're never sure what you're going to get, but it's always going to be something delicious.
Awesome.
Dennis, thank you for visiting. Folks, we'll see you next time at Jason's Table, the Fruit Lab. Bye.
Cheers.